Let's apply the Lewis dot structure rules to this compound, ammonia, NH3. First of all, let's use the S equals N minus A rule to decide how many bonds are present in this particular compound. S, of course, is the total number of shared electrons. N is the number of electrons needed if each atom comes to the compound with its octet satisfied. And A is actually the available number of valence electrons in the compound. So N, in this case, we have one nitrogen, N needed. We have one nitrogen. Nitrogen needs 8 electrons to satisfy its octet. So that's 8. Hydrogen, we have 3 hydrogen atoms in this compound. Now hydrogen, because it's so small and it's in period 1, it only needs 2 electrons. You need to remember that. Most elements need 8 electrons to satisfy their octet, their valence octet. But nitrogen only needs 2 to satisfy what's called its octet. So that'd be a total of 8 plus, this is 6. So the total number of electrons needed here to satisfy this compound is 14. Okay. Now let's figure out the number of, so this was all needed. Let me make this more clear. These were the electrons that were needed. Oops. Now let's look at how many electrons are actually available to work with here. Okay, we have one nitrogen, and the available is literally how many valence electrons. Nitrogen is in group 5 or 15, so it's got 5 valence electrons, so that would be 5. Hydrogen, there's 3 of them. Hydrogen's in group 1, it has 1 valence electron, so that's 3. So the total number of available electrons is 8. So the atoms come to this compound with just 8 available electrons, but we need 14. So to figure out the number of bonds, we need to figure out the number of shared electrons. It's going to be 14 minus 8 equals 6. So the number of bonds is equal to the total number of shared electrons divided by 2. So like 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. So we expect 3 bonds. According to the rules, typically the first element listed is the central atom. And so nitrogen would be central. Hydrogen is always terminal, so each hydrogen is going to be bound to that central atom with a shared pair of electrons. So we had a total of, we see 8 electrons to work with here. We've used up 2, 4, 6. Okay, so we only have 2 more electrons because the only electrons we have to put in the molecule are the available electrons. So we've used 6 of our 8, and according to the rules, it says that check that all of the atoms have satisfied the octet rule and that all of the available electrons have been assigned. That's not the case. If the central atom has fewer than 8 electrons, that's our problem right now, but all the terminal atoms are satisfied, they are, add electron pairs to the central atom. So in this case, those 2 more electrons that we have to use can't go on any of the hydrogens, plus all the hydrogens are satisfied. So we place them on the central atom. So now the central atom 2, 4, 6, 8 has 8 valence electrons. Each hydrogen has 2 valence electrons. It's satisfied. You see here 2, 2, 2. And then when you look at the nitrogen, you look at all the electrons around the nitrogen like that. So the Lewis structure has 1 non-bonding pair of electrons or unshared pair of electrons on the central atom, and then 3 bonding pairs. So this is the correct Lewis structure for ammonia following the rules.